Friends, how are you? Hope you're having a great day. What I'm going to do today is I'm going to share with you what happened on a contract that canceled last week on a, with a buyer I was helping. Two, I'm going to share with you a horror story avoided with a someone who was buying a house and narrowly avoided a huge issue. And I'm going to give you a little bit of information about what the real estate's doing here in the month of September of 2019. Now, let's talk about what happened to our contract. Under contract, negotiating repairs, buyer wanted very reasonable things to be addressed and some money in lieu of repairs on one item that was a fairly big item, not a lot of money, a couple thousand dollars. However, it was something material to the buyer. Seller would not acquiesce on anything at all on the repair list, so buyer opted to terminate the contract. Well, within their rights, totally support that. It was a good decision for them, because they weren't comfortable with those terms. They felt totally taken advantage of. So, seller agent, listing agent and I stay engaged. Listing agent saying, what can we do to get this done? We, you know, sellers want to sell. What can we do? I said, sellers want to sell. Give them the money, the buyers the money that they asked for, and the buyers might re-engage and might take the house. Got a phone call last night. Seller totally reconsidered, going to give 100% of the money that the buyer wanted. Miracle. And we're under contract today and moving forward. Great news for the buyers. They're happy. They want the house. That's super great story for them. And good news for the seller, because they don't have to go back on the market again. Moral of that story, number one, is just because the contract terminates doesn't mean it can't be reinstated. Sometimes after parties think it through, they realize, man, maybe I could be a little more flexible than I was being, and the contract gets reinstated. Two, don't be penny wise, pound foolish, sellers. You should know going into this process that there's a $1,000 to $3,000 little window of buyer requested repairs. It's usually between $1,000 and $3,000. Put that in your budget. It's a line item in the budget. Take that into consideration when you're negotiating price. It won't be a surprise for you when you get that repair amendment, and it makes the process less emotional, less of a roller coaster, and it's an easy, smooth sailing process or ship once you know this is going to happen. So just be prepared for that. What happened in this other horror story? Wow, did this person dodge a huge bullet? So I wasn't involved in it, so I'm just going to recap kind of what I was told. Buyer buying a house, going to closing. The day of closing was this week. Buyer learns from the neighbor, A, there's raw sewage that backs up in the house or in the yard somewhere on the property. Raw sewage is backing up frequently, so much so that the previous tenants had a problem with the landlord about it. It was a rent house, and it was a common problem for sewage to back up. And two, the house had foundation repair in the recent past, and it wasn't disclosed by the seller, but yet the seller had disclosed other material repairs, just not the foundation. So were they hiding something? Don't know. Maybe they forgot, but it sure seems like they forgot to tell everyone that the sewage is leaking. And oh, by the way, per the neighbor, they forgot to tell on the seller's disclosure that several plumbers had quoted repairing that sewage line. So there was allegedly a lot of evidence that this seller had knowledge about significant defects and wasn't disclosing them. So had this buyer close on this house and these things came to light a month, 2 months, 6 months down the road, that buyer would have had recourse against that seller, because the neighbor sounds like would have helped them by giving them the names of the companies and so on and so forth. So two lessons here. One, I wasn't involved in the transaction, so I can't speak to the competency of the buyer's agent, but it seems to me there's a lot of other details I'm leaving out, but it seems to me like maybe that buyer's agent missed a few things that they could have possibly caught these problems, or at least caught the fact that the seller did not disclose some material items. So that's just something that in my mind I'm questioning. And two, sellers, don't lie. Don't hide these types of issues. You're going to go to court and you're going to get sued, and there's a high probability you're going to lose. No one wants that situation. If this would have been the case, I don't know, I'm not an attorney, so I can't speak to what would happen. But the attorney that this person, that the buyer did speak to, did tell them that you're out of the contract. It's very easy. Just tell the seller this, this, and this, and this, and they're going to let you out. And they did. So good that the buyer dodged that bullet. Bad that the seller was allegedly or apparently attempting to fraudulently sell this house by not disclosing some material defects. So be very, very careful when you're in that process of due diligence. Make sure you dot all your I's, cross all your T's, and it sounds to me like some were missed on the buy side. But fortunately, that turned out well for the buyer. Third, let's talk about really quickly what's going on in the real estate market in September, middle of the month, 2019. Down below are some reports. First, market is doing well. I'm actually seeing a little bit of a decline in new listings coming on, which is good because we still have a good stable demand, but that's going to stop the market from expanding in terms of time on market needed to sell houses. That's going to slow down a little bit as there's less inventory coming on. So that's great news. There's some information down below about very large communities being built, ironically, north and east of the Metroplex. One of the articles talks about Collin County being one of the biggest growth counties in the area, and now east, the second, another big growth area, and that's where they're building affordable housing. Affordable being like under 400, under 300. You got to go north pretty far, Salina, up along 380. You have to prosper. You have to go out east to Rowlett, Rockwall, Fate, and Farmersville. You got to go way far out east, or you got to go far north. But they're building affordable housing. And one of the developments mentioned below is 6,000 houses coming in. That's huge. And I got to believe that that's going to be 400,000 and under, not 600, 700, 800. I think it's going to be more of the entry-level to mid-level priced houses. So market is doing really well, folks. The key thing, and I touched on this a couple weeks ago, price your house correctly and it will sell. Just because you have it upgraded or partially upgraded doesn't mean you can charge $225 a foot. You have to charge what fair market value for your neighborhood is, for what your product is. Hope these items help you guys. If you have any questions, please call, text, or email me. I'm here to help. Have a great day.